have a collaboration tattoo coming up.
Yeah, yeah, and this is going to be a sort of a two-day event, kind of inspired by the thing that Jeff Gogue and I did in I guess it was February, where the first day was open to the public. Anyone could tune in and watch, and we didn't talk really about any technical stuff, but we did talk a lot about design preparation and you know, all kinds of other stuff, took audience questions. And then the second day was a paid seminar where we really got down and dirty and talked technical and took technical type questions from the online audience, and it was a lot of fun. And so yeah, we've got kind of a big project coming up for October. Russ, you want to talk about it a little bit?
Yeah, sure. I know that we're doing a full leg, and I know that we are, the goal is to combine my ornamental style with your biomech style. So I imagine just giant swoopy curvy shapes, you know, matching the flow of the leg, and maybe a few focal points that are kind of maybe like light form based or mandala based. And then I imagine you coming in and laying on all those textures on top and having a lot of input as far as design goes as well. Does that sound about right, or?
Oh, something along those lines. The way that I've kind of enjoyed collaborations the most, I really like when both parties are involved in every part of the project, where you've really got a mix, like there's a third artist in the room that can only exist when those two are working together, rather than having this person's parts and this other person's parts, which that can work too, but I really can imagine our styles very seamlessly fusing. The ornamental stuff kind of, it follows a lot of the same rules and principles that biomech does, in terms of flow and space, volume, kind of a three-dimensional effect that, even back in the Victorian days when they were, creating this stuff, they were trying to simulate a three-dimensional effect where it was painted in such a way that it was meant to appear carved. So, it seems like it would be a great mutation of the two.
Yeah, I think so. I'm really excited about the idea of, seeing how you work and getting a feel for what your process is.
Russ, have you done many collaborations in the past?
Yeah, I've done a couple of with Nate Beavers, with Mike Chambers. Trying to think. I feel like there's a few more that I'm not recalling at the moment. They were always like that, where we created the drawing together, and both of us were kind of melded into it, rather than having separate pieces that were uniquely ours. So I'm with you on the process.
So what are some of the things that you can take away from a collaboration, Guy?
Well, it gives you a chance to kind of shamelessly play around in this other artist's workspace. You're not copying or ripping off their style. You've been kind of invited in to see what you can do with it. And, of course, you're working together, so it's going to end up containing both artists' voices. Sometimes it's a one nice way to start is to, one artist will do a very rough sketch. Instead of just passing the sketch over, to actually scan it and reprint it extremely light to where the drawing's visible. But while you're drawing on top of that, directly on the print, it's very easy to change stuff and take it in different directions while keeping the most essential, important, or favorite aspects of it. So at very root level, what you're going to take home from it is a chance to broaden your style a little bit, to take some of the things that this other artist does and find a completely different twist on it, because inevitably you're going to. You're not going to end up working like this other artist. You're going to end up bringing things home from them that are, clearly influenced by them, but it's always going to end up being your own twist.
Russ, do you find the same thing to be true? Do you you take things away that you wouldn't normally get from tattooing?
Yeah, that's exactly right, and you'll always pick up on some little technique that you never considered before. There's just, you could never realize the subtleties of someone else's technique until you work side by side with them and just watch every little thing that they're doing and question everything. It's just the opportunity to vocalize what you're thinking and have someone else kind of in tune to that and check it, that's, you know, really rare. A collaboration is the way to do that. And I think that's what's really cool about the process of teaching in this way too, because other people are going to be able to hear me question you and you question me, and they're going to get to hear those explanations.
Will you guys be showing the folks watching the design process? Will that be something that they'll be able to see?
Parts of it, yeah. I think that there's going to be some aspects that we're going to be starting a little bit earlier in preparation for this, because it is a fairly epic piece, and we'll probably end up emailing some sketches back and forth before we get too deep into it. So we'll be able to show you those. There will be parts of the process that we may film in the day prior and show you, and then there'll be parts that you'll be able to actually watch. I think we're going to end up stenciling some things and freehanding others. I'm guessing freehanding is a great way to get the best possible flow, while stenciling allows you to get much more precise results. And you know, I think part of the objective of this project is we're going to have some areas of it where we're going to get into that that kind of, you know, incredible looking 3D relief geometric stuff that Russ has been doing. Although I can totally imagine some things to do with that would be a completely different take on it. So that'll be another great way for us to mix our styles.
What are some of the potential like issues or pitfalls that might come with two different styles? You guys have very similar aspects in some ways and very different aspects in others. Are there any potential problems with a clash of style?
I think probably I'm not really concerned about that, because I feel like, you know, we're both going to be involved in the decision-making process, and you know, I think we're both going to have to give a little bit, and we're both going to give a lot, you know? So I've never really had an issue with any problems. What about you, Guy?
Well, I mean, I think that the whole reason why we sort of floated this project in the first place is because there's a compatibility here, you know? What you're doing with ornament, what I'm doing with biomech, your geometric stuff. I mean, this is all stuff I can totally relate to. I think that ornament and bio follow such parallel principles that I just can't see how it couldn't be a winning combination, you know? And I think that we also have a lot of mutual respect for what each other does. And, you know, that always makes, I think that's actually essential for a good collaboration. Because then, you know, each artist is making sure that there's a strong balance, a clear, you know, 50-50 balance of influences in the piece.
I'm really looking forward to it. So we're gonna have people here in Easthampton live with both of you guys, and as well as people tuning in online. I think it's gonna be a good time. How long of a tattoo do you think we're gonna expect from this? You guys gonna go into the wee hours like you did with Jeff, Guy?
We'll go, I think, as long as we're all able to go. I mean, I do the wee hours. When you have clients that are traveling long distances, and pretty much exclusively that's your whole clientele, you just learn to do that. And it's not that I prefer it. I think that because we're going to have a lot of preparation that we're going to be showing people, you know, a lot of the freehanding and that kind of thing we're going to be, you know, doing on camera. I just don't see how we could possibly start very early. So, you know, it's probably going to take us at least to midnight on both nights. We're not going to be laying out the entire leg. We're going to be doing two large panels on the outside of the leg, and we're going to be working on the rest of the leg at each other's studios later on.
We've got a three camera setup that should be really great for people to see. We tested it out with Rember's webinar and it went really well. So I'm confident that we should have a really great three-camera setup for this collaboration.
I'm psyched to see the razor-sharp HD multi-angle footage that we're going to get of this thing.
As well am I.
You know, I'm excited about this collaboration for sure. This is kind of a dream come true.